already looked at how to create event frame-based reports in RtReports, but it's also possible to make time-based reports. In this video, you will learn how to do it. Time report templates allow users to configure report templates that can be generated for a specific time range and/or recurrence pattern. The report template is generated against an overall time range. In addition, the overall time range can be further divided into relative or fixed duration time spans that allows users to create detailed time reports with hierarchical timeframes or interrelated time ranges. Let's move on to an exercise and configure a time-based report using AF element attribute information. We will begin by creating a new time report template. In order to do so, go to File and select New Time Report Template. For the name, type Time Report. For the recurrence, select None and click on OK. Now we will add an asset context template under the time report template. Switch to the data template tab, select time template, insert asset context template. Click on the magnifying glass next to the template name field. A search window should open up. Select server PyServer 01, database DDatabase, find the RX template, and click on OK. Click on OK one more time. Now let's add a journal action for compressed values result definitions of PHAF attribute of the 1K reactors. In the Data Template tab, expand Time. Right-click on the RX template. Insert Journal Action. Name COM Volume. Under Action Parameters, click on the green plus icon to add a new action parameter. For the name, type Attribute 1. Select type AF Attribute. Make sure you are connected to server PyServer 01 and database DDatabase. In the search results, expand 1K reactors, R1001 attributes, select PH. Click on OK. Select Relative Path and click on OK. Now go to Journal Action Edit Results Definitions tab and click on the green plus icon. For the name, type COM Value and select the type Compressed Values. Now you can drag Attribute 1 from the left to the data source on the right. Click on OK. Save and test your report. To do so, go to View, Test Report, select Data Server PyServer 01, Asset Server PyServer 01, Asset Database, DDatabase, Start Time asterisk minus 1H, End Time asterisk. Now we will modify the format template to display the unit name, the AF attribute and PI point names and the compressed values. So go to Format Template tab, right-click on Time Report, Insert, Section. For the node name, type RX Section. Switch to the Expressions tab. Find and drag time-based root journal journals asset context journal from the journal to the iterator field and click on OK. Expand RX section, right-click on Entry, Insert, Paragraph and click on OK. Right-click on Paragraph, Insert Text. Type a unit name. Right-click on paragraph again, insert, data, browse and drag the unit name data item from the journal to the source field. Click on OK. Right-click on Entry, Insert Trace Set, Node Name PH Measurements Table. Browse and drag to the source field the item displayed on the screen. Switch to the Rows Definition tab and click on the red X icon to remove columns, Error Code, Error Description, and is good. Now go to the Border tab for the Frame Select Border and for the Border Width 1 and click on OK. Right-click on the table header under the PH Measurements table, select Insert Table Row. Right-click on Table Row, Insert Table Data. Right-click on Table Data, Insert Text, Type Attribute. Right-click on Table Data, Insert Data. Find in the journal and drag to the source field the item you can see on the screen and click on OK. Right-click again on the table header under the PH Measurements table, Insert Table Row. Right-click on Table Row, Insert Table Data. Right-click on Table Data, Insert Text, Type Tag. Right-click on Table Data, Insert Data. Find in the journal and drag to the source field the data item you can see on the screen and click on OK. Save your report template and click on Refresh or hit F5 on your keyboard. Our report is ready, although you may notice that there are three key areas where improvements can be made. Firstly, let's address the spacing of the first two rows of the table, specifically the attribute and tag names. We will extend them so that they align with the rest of the table. Next, we will rearrange the order in which the units are displayed to have them in ascending order, ensuring that unit R1001 is displayed first. Additionally, we will refine the decimal precision of pH values to 2 digits. To do so, switch to Format Template, Extend RX Section, Entry pH Measurements Table, Table Row, double-click Table Data, change the column span to 2. Repeat the above steps for the second table data. Save your report and click on Refresh. In order to change the number of displayed decimal places, double-click the pH Measurements table. Go to Rows Definition tab, change the value format to F2. Save your report and click on Refresh. Now switch to Data Template, double-click the RX template and select Ascending Sort Order. Save your report and refresh to see the changes. Your report is ready. Thanks for watching.